Now we will see the biosynthesis of purine nucleotide. If you see the pathway, it majorly occurs in liver and it is a cytosolic process. Certain tissues and cells like brain cells, RBCs, neutrophils, they do not undergo de novo purine nucleotide biosynthesis. Brain cells, you actually depends on salvage pathway for purine synthesis. Coming to the requirements, so this biosynthetic pathway requires an activated molecule, that is activated ribose 5-phosphate, otherwise called as PRPP. Coming to the enzymes, now we can see there are various steps. There are 10 steps in this pathway. So there are 10 different or various enzymes which are catalyzing these reactions, and these enzymes are multifunctional catalysts. In prokaryotes, each reaction is catalyzed by a different polypeptide. But in eukaryotes, due to gene fusion, single polypeptide with multiple catalytic functions are seen. In this regard, we have three distinct multifunctional enzymes. The first, which catalyzes the reaction, second, third, and fifth. Then second enzyme we have, which catalyzes the reaction 6 and 7. And we have one more enzyme, which catalyzes the reaction 9 and 10. So coming to the energy, this process requires 6 high energy phosphate. So it is very much energy dependent process. Apart from this, this biosynthetic pathway also requires amino acids like glycine, aspartate, and derivatives like glutamine. And coenzymes like N5, N10 formal tetrahydrofolate. Some books gives this as N10 formal tetrahydrofolate. Along with this, we also request N10 formal tetrahydrofolate and carbon dioxide. Now we will briefly learn about the purine biosynthesis. It should be noted that purines are not produced as free bases. Rather, they are synthesized piece by piece upon a pre-existing ribose 5-phosphate. In the first step, glutamine donates its amido nitrogen to PRPP, displacing the pyrophosphate and thereby creating N to C bond. So this N becomes the N9 of purine, and this is C is the C1 of ribose 5-phosphate. So there is N-glycosidic linkage formation, and the enzyme which catalyzes this reaction is glutamide PRPP amidotransferase. This enzyme is not present in brain and RBC. That's why they solely depend on salvage pathway for purine nucleotide biosynthesis. Apart from this, this step is a committed and a rate limiting step. Committed means once PRPP undergoes this reaction, then it should follow the purine biosynthesis. This enzyme is under feedback regulation. So once this reaction happens, we have formation of phosphoribosyl amine, abbreviated as PRA. In the second step, this PRA, that is phosphoribosylamine, condenses with glycine in presence of ATP to form GAR. GAR is nothing but glycinamide ribotide or ribonucleotide. So in this reaction, glycine donates or provides atoms which will become C4, C5 and N7 of purine ring. Next, we will see what happens to this glycinamide ribonucleotide. So now N10, N5, N10 methanyl tetrahydrofolate, and some books gives as N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate. So this molecule donates the formyl group to the GAR to form FGAR. FGAR is nothing but formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide. So there is formation of this C8. In the next step, glutamine transfers the second amide nitrogen to the growing ring to form formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide. So this reaction requires ATP. Now you know this is the N3 of purine ring. Now this FGAM is converted to AR, that is aminoimidazole ribonucleotide, once there is closure of this ring. So in purine biosynthesis, the smaller ring is the one, that is imidazole ring is the one which is synthesized first. So this purine imidazole ring is closed in an ATP dependent reaction to form AR. Now there is insertion of carbon dioxide as C6 of purine yielding CAIR, that is carboxy alpha iminoimidazole ribotide, so otherwise called as amino carboxy aminoimidazole ribonucleotide. This is a special reaction you should remember. Even though it is a carboxylation reaction or carbon dioxide reaction, carbon dioxide fixation reaction catalyzed by AIR carboxylase, this is biotin independent and also it does not require any ATP. In the next step, the N1 of purine is contributed by the condensation of aspartate. So there is condensation of aspartate with CAIR to form SICAR. So ATP is required in this process. So now this aspartate actually donates the N1 of purine ring. Next, the adenylosuccinate lyase enzyme cleaves this SICAR to release fumarate. So fumaric acid is released, leaving behind an amino group of aspartate in the purine ring. So now you can see from the aspartate, fumarate is released, leaving behind the amino group of aspartate in the purine ring. So this resultant compound is 5-aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide, otherwise abbreviated as AICAR. Now the reactions of these two are identical in the urea cycle, in which citrulline is aminated to form arginine. The final atom of purine ring, that is C2, is obtained by N10 formyl tetrahydrofolate. So during this reaction, formyl group is transferred onto AICAR by the enzyme transformylase to convert AICAR to FICAR, FAICAR. Then the final reaction of purine biosynthetic pathway is catalyzed by cyclohydrohydrolase or otherwise IMP synthase, which leads the closure of purine ring with the elimination of water molecule. So the end product obtained in the biosynthetic pathway of purine is IMP. So IMP is the first purine nucleotide formed. In this slide, you can see the summary of how the purine nucleotide is synthesized step by step manner. So already you know the ring is built on ribose 5-phosphate activated molecule, that is PRPP. So in the step 1, so we will just take the pointer. So in the step 1, glutamine donates the nitrogen, which is at 9th position. So N9 is actually donated by glutamine. In the second full position, in the second step, there is formation of C4, C5 and N7, and the donor is glycine. In the third step, there is formation of C8 molecule, that is donor is N5, N10, methionine, tetrahydrofolate. In step 4, again the glutamine donates the second amidonitrogen, that is at third position. And the fifth step is the ring closure of imidazole ring of purine is closed. In the sixth step, the C6 is formed and the donor is carbon dioxide. In the step 7, N1 is formed and aspartate is the donor. In the eighth step, fumarate is removed. And in the ninth step, C2 is formed and the carbon donor is 10-formyl tetrahydrofolate. In the 10th step, again the ring closure. Finally, the first purine nucleotide formed is IMP, that is inosine monophosphate.